Bringing Down the Moon by Jonathan Emmett. Hot diggity, exclaimed Mole as he burrowed out of the ground one night. Whatever's that? The moon was hanging in the sky above him like a bright silver coin. Mole thought it was the most beautiful thing he'd ever seen. Whatever it is, I must have it, Mole said to himself. I know, I'll jump up and pull it down. Thump, thump, thumpity bump. Mole was so busy jumping he did not think about the noise he was making, and he woke up Rabbit in her burrow. Mole, said Rabbit, what on earth are you doing? Hello, Rabbit, said Mole. I'm trying to pull down the shiny thing. You mean the moon, asked Rabbit. So that's what it's called, said Mole. You'll never do that, said Rabbit. It's not as near as it looks. But Mole would not give up. I know. He thought, I'll get a stick and poke it down, and he found a long stick and poked it up in the moon. Swish, swish, swishity, swish. Mole was so busy poking that he tripped over Hedgehog and his bed of leaves. Mole, grunted Hedgehog, what in the weave are you up to? Hello, Hedgehog, said Mole. I'm trying to poke down the moon. You'll never do that, said Hedgehog. It's not as near as it looks. But Mole would not give up. I know, he thought, I'll throw something at it and knock it down. He found some acorns and threw them at the moon. Plink, plink, plinkety plink. Ouch, said Squirrel. Mole, have you gone nuts? Hello, Squirrel, said Mole. I'm trying to knock down the moon. You will never do that, said Squirrel. It's not as near as it looks. But Mole wanted the moon so badly. He would not give up. I know, he thought, I'll climb the tree and fetch it down. Mole had never climbed a tree before, and it was hard work, and he was scared to be so far from the ground. But he kept on going until he saw the moon resting up on the leaves above him. Mole stretched out his paws, but just when he thought he had made the moon, he slipped. Oh, eek, ouch, oh! Mole tumbled down and landed splash in the middle of a puddle. Hot dang diggity drat, thought the mole. I'm almost had it that time. Then he noticed something floating in the puddle beside him. It was a pale, wrinkled, but Mole recognised it at once. The moon, whispered Mole. He must have fallen down with me. And he reached out to pick up the moon, but as soon as he touched it, it broke into pieces and vanished. Mole sat in the puddle and cried. Rabbit, Hedgehog and Squirrel came running up. Are you alright, Mole? Asked Rabbit. I am alright, sobbed Mole, but the moon isn't. I pulled it down and then I broke it. And it was so beautiful and now I shall never see it again. Oh, Mole, said Rabbit. You couldn't have pulled it down, the moon down. And you couldn't have broke it, said Hedgehog. And you certainly see it again, said the Squirrel. Look, high up in the sky above them, the moon was coming out behind the clouds. Oh, whispered the Mole. And it's as beautiful as ever. Mole, Rabbit and Hedgehog, Squirrel stood and stared up at the moon together. It is beautiful, said Rabbit. Very beautiful, said Hedgehog. And very beautiful indeed, said Squirrel. Yes, said Mole, but it's not as near as it looks.